My name is Brendan Meyers, and today we're gonna be talking about the steps to getting your sixth ab. All right, so we're gonna give you a pre-bonus type thing today, and we're gonna get started with making sure that you are riding in a Fiat 500E. All right, so pre-bonus check. Now we're gonna go over to the grocery store. Nutrition is going to be key. You need to pay close attention to this because I'm telling you right now, if you do not do this, the sixth ab will not arrive. Excuse me. Okay, so step one, we are here at Ralph's. We don't go to Whole Foods, too expensive. So we're gonna grab some Quilted Northern Ultra Soft and Strong. Of course, toilet paper. This is going to be an intense day, so let's get it. We're gonna be grabbing watermelons. You need watermelons, trust me on this. Okay, we are still on step one. We're about to be leaving Ralph's, and we're gonna need to grab a pen. This is gonna be very important. You need to take notes. Take notes, let's go. All right, step two. And by the way, I wanna say this. I do have my exercise physiology degree. I'm very qualified to be making this video for you. We are going to hop onto YouTube. You're already here. Check out my ab workout, my latest one. And you need to get ready. Seriously, get it ready on another phone, whatever you gotta do. And now let's hit step three. All right, so when you really talk about these watermelons that I purchased, remember, this is step three. Oh, okay. And you just really need to make sure when you're focused on all these different things, you just gotta keep those going. Even if it gets rough and just like it feels like a lot of pain. Oh, you just gotta keep on going. And as you're done, you know, you just wanna focus on getting those extra reps and really looking at all this bullshit and saying, this is enough. All of this is a joke again. And I wanted to come in with a banger because look, the problem that I've been seeing time and time again is you are being misinformed on how to truly build a six pack, to build that core. And I don't want you to steer off path. I want you to understand exactly how to do it and give you examples. And so within this video, the rest of the video, I'm going to give you some information that will get you to that next step. Number one, you have to understand that the lower your body fat percentage, the better you are going to look at your midsection, right? If you are 20% body fat, it's going to affect you. If you are 17% body fat, it's going to affect you where you're not going to really be able to see those abdominal muscles. And remember, your abs consist of multiple things. You have your transverse abdominis, you have your external obliques, your internal obliques, you also have your rectus abdominis, and you need to understand that there's many parts or components to that midsection. Don't worry, I'm not in pain. That felt great. Just a little, a little mold on my face. But next, when we really talk about lowering that body fat percentage, obviously it's a deficit. So you look at your calories, just focus on that. It's pretty simple. We talk about it in every single video. Every fitness YouTuber and influencer and person online explains it. Just get that deficit right where you need to be. So you're losing that fat per week. Remember, I talked about it in my last video on how to lose that body fat percentage. Now, don't wanna be using this crap supplements that you see all over, like these fat burners to try and burn off that fat over that midsection. It's going to just cause negative effects elsewhere in your body and long term. You don't want to have these negative effects long term. You really want to focus on the proper diets and the nutrition and that deficit. It's very simple, okay? Then next, you don't want to be taking this trend or testosterone because everyone else is doing it online. Yes, there's competitors that do it. Yes, there's other people that do it for like powerlifting and specific federations and stuff. But what you need to be focusing on is just that nutrition. I cannot explain it enough. And then obviously your consistency is going to be key. If you are training your abs once a week or you're doing movements that are not really compound movements, there's multi-joint movements that requires your core or function movements that require your core to stabilize, that you're not gonna be really using that midsection as much as you should be. And remember, your core isn't only your anterior side, it's your posterior side. You have your rectus spinae that go all the way up your spine, and you also have your QLs. You need to be working all these muscles, your glutes, everything around this midsection area, okay? And then finally, use resistance in your training. If you can't and you're only bodyweight training, then so be it. That's fine. Do my ab workouts every other day or every third day or every second day, and you will be good to go. I think second day and every other day is the same exact thing, but you get my point. Now, what I wanna do is I wanna show you a few examples of movements that you could be doing that is resistance filled. Remember, your abdominals are muscles. They're muscles, just like your chest, just like your shoulders, just like your legs, your quads, your hamstrings, your calves, everything. Even though everyone thinks you can't build your calf muscles, you can. It's just a muscle, and you have to work it in a way that is hypertrophy filled with resistance and a high enough volume, especially in your core, because you're using it every single day. So what I want to do right now is go through multiple movements and take a dumbbell, which I'm going to do right here. I'm actually in my house, so I didn't want to go to a gym because not everybody wants to go to a gym to work their abs, right? So I have myself a 5-pound dumbbell. I have a couple more dumbbells downstairs that I can grab if I want to, but resistance, right? You can be doing multiple movements. I'm not gonna go through all of them. Maybe I'll make a video about resistance on your abs. I don't even know why I'm talking like this, but let's just jump right into it, all right? We have the dumbbell, and we're gonna come right down here. So you're gonna find a wall, find some type of wall. I'm gonna go through three different movements. We're gonna come all the way down on our backs. Most important thing, necks. You don't wanna be flexing so much. It puts a lot of strain on that spine. Tuck in that chin. We're gonna be pushing up against the wall as hard as we can, okay? And then we're gonna be putting our feet, our dumbbell in between our feet the whole time. So we're gonna be here, all right? And as you can see, dumbbell's down there. My hands are here, I'm gonna be pushing up against here. And then I'm just gonna come right back in. And the main thing is to squeeze your core as much as possible and make sure that that low spine is not extending, right? So you don't want it to be here. You don't want that round curvature. You want it to be tight and controlled the whole time. So again, you're gonna be right here. And I like to do anything from, let's say, 6 repetitions to 13 repetitions. It's hypertrophy, right? So you're gonna come here and come back down. Now, another thing that you don't wanna do is bring those knees too high, because now our low spine, again, is at risk. So you wanna come up to here where it's like very controlled and come right back down. So it's exercise number one. Number two, and this one's gonna be really, really tough. Now this is gonna be working just like that one is, a little bit of hip flexors, but more so your core is going to be screaming, your posterior and your anterior side. Without a resistance, you can come here, right? Your feet are gonna be 6 inches off the ground, you're gonna be here, and you're gonna be rocking around as you see. Great camera work. And then what you can do is add a resistance up here if you would like, right? So you're coming around here. Main thing is to not have a carpet right here, but main thing is to just stabilize as you're twisting your hips. So you're going from one butt cheek to another. One butt cheek to another. Or you can also put it at the bottom of your feet. I don't recommend this too much, but hey, it is very, very challenging. Main thing is, you see my neck? It was like all the way like flexed. You want it to be in that nice neutral position, okay? And then exercise number three. It's gonna be a little bit different. You haven't seen this too often, but hey, you could be using it in many of your workouts, even if you're doing any type of back workouts, movements, or anything for your serratus. This is gonna be a really cool movement that you could be doing. So you're here, all right? You have a dumbbell in each side, and you're gonna be as so. So tuck in that chin, and it's gonna be here. Boom, boom. Now, if you have low back problems, do not do this movement, all right, here. And it's to the other side, here. And with this movement, and the last movement that I showed you, so the one that we were twisting around, that movement we're gonna be doing anywhere, again, 6 to 13 repetitions, all the way around, all the way back. Higher volume, which means higher sets. You can have rest periods, it's fine. Your abdominals are worked more often, so the rest period should be a little bit lower. So instead of like 45 seconds, maybe 30 seconds, 20 seconds, even 15 to 10 seconds, you can move down to that low of a rest period. And then that last movement that I just did, you can go ahead and do around 8 repetitions on each side. So that is an example of some resistance exercises. Very simple. The more resistance you have on that core area, posterior and anterior, obviously you wanna do some different movements like glute ham raise and stuff for your posterior side, for that whole posterior chain. But like for that anterior side to get that 6th ab, it's right there, everything you need. So what are you doing? Go get started. Give this video a thumbs up if you enjoyed. If you really want to show me some love, then comment down below, give me some love, and subscribe if you haven't already. Thanks for tuning in, and I'll see you next time. Peace. Come at me fast. Ready? And go. And step 3, let's get to work.